really late. Why? Because there's so many people who have heard of you. There's so many people who want to know more of you since you have found your newfound love. Can I say that, since you found your new
friend? Oh, yes, darling. I've never been in love like this, and I've never been in love like this. That's what I keep telling people every day. You never in love until you love like this,
man,
you know?
Can I tell you? Powerful. All right, so stay online with me.
You haven't been through some things, then you can't have testimony. This song is dedicated to women. Women who have been raped. Women who have been beaten. Women who have been forced to prostitution. Women who have been addicted to drugs. Broken women. Women who should have been dead women. Standing today because of a man named Jesus. I've been beaten. I've gone through a whole lot of struggle. But I never lose my faith.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Inside the Zone. It's a Monday drive, keeping you in the know in the city you walk, drive, and reside. With me online is Minister Marion Hall, and I am so happy to be talking with this woman of God. And what a privilege to say that, because there was a time when they would be making friends to you, Minister Hall, as, you know, the girl Lady Saul or something.
Yes.
But now, I am, as a woman of God, I treasure those who have lived a life, because we were all sinners until he stepped in. He has stepped in many different ways. I tell you, we've all fallen short, and he has stepped in many different ways, and he has met us when he knew the time was right. It's all about timing. And by the way, I just want to say to you that you are looking absolutely great. I love the latest pic that you have out. Your bio pic is awesome, and I want to know, what is Antidote? Where can we buy it?
You know, when I was out there in the world, you know, I remember people asked me, what do you do to stay so young? I said, stress. But then, since I got saved, there's this glow, this light that I know. It's just me walking in that light, you know, the Jesus light. Mm-hmm. That's where I got that glow from. Sometimes I look at myself in the mirror and I'm like, you know, something really changed. I said, Lord, you keep this light on me. Don't take this light off me. I do all I have to do to get this light shining through me all the time.
You are wonderful. Looking fabulous. So I'd like to welcome you to the segment that I call A Woman Born Again. A Woman Born Again. Now, can we say your album release, When God Speaks, that took place on July 22nd. But before we talk about the album, let's do a quick recap. The world woke up to the greatest news. You declared you wanted God to change your life. How would you best describe Marion today?
Wow, the world woke up. I woke up on the 14th of December 2016. I mean, I had encounters with God before, but that day was more powerful than ever. I never had such a long conversation with him here, and that is why the album is titled When God Speaks.
Mm-hmm.
How do I describe Marion now? Marion is all about learning the word, everything about him. I want to know more about God. I mean, I grew up, you know, with some powerful women, my great-grandmother, you know, my grandmother, and my great-grandfather's wife was a woman of God. She was so powerful. She used to be a messenger for Christ. She would go out and deliver message. So I was very close to her. She always tell me she'll never leave me. Today, Marion is a woman who God has taken from a mansion and put her in a one-bedroom, and she's so happy and at peace in there by herself. My walls are engulfed in scriptures from the Bible. I have a teacher. I don't know. God placed in my life, but he's on the TV every day. That's where he is. His name is Pastor Arnold Murray. And the first day I saw him, I was just addicted. I was hooked. And I started watching him. He read Bible, like, he teaches the Bible, like, chapter by chapter, verse by verse. I also went and purchased The Strong. He has two books that he always referred to. He always tells his students to get, and it's, one of them is The New Strong, and it's a concordance of the Bible. And there's also one, The Companion Bible. So I have Bible all over the place. I have Greek and Hebrews in it, and I'm laughing like, when am I going to learn Hebrews and Greek? You know,
yes.
So my life is all about God, about learning his word. You know, when I first got saved, there were so many people, they almost crucified me.
Mm-hmm.
And I was paranoid, like I keep running. Somebody say, is that Marion? Or somebody say, is that me? I say hi, and I run. You know, I just start find myself running away from people. But I can tell you today that I have no reason to run. You know, my God have me equipping me with a word, and each time somebody throws something at me, the scripture for that.
Oh, amen.
You know?
Amen.
Yeah,
so you have your fiery darts going on.
Yes. He wants me to, he had sent somebody to me, a messenger, and I know I should go to the Bible school, so that's what I'm doing, like studying stuff from now on, you know, from now, so when I get in there, it's more easy
for you.
For me, you
that's
know?
Right.
Yeah.
That's a good way to
that's
do it.
That's my goal.
Wonderful.
Yeah.
If you're just joining me, ladies and gentlemen, my guest this evening is Minister Marion Hall, formerly known as Lady Saw. Now, can we talk about your album release, When God Speaks? And I have pointed three themes for you. I'd like you to talk about the journey, the title, and the message.
Okay. The journey is wonderful. At first it was like when I told you when I got saved, and my own people, I thought like they would embrace me and say, you know, congratulations, we praying you up, you know, we wish you well, you know, it's the best thing you ever did. But I was surprised that people was all over the internet bashing me. People were saying she's doing this for the money, but what money? Because I had money. You know, I had properties and houses and cars. I've been there, done that, and I'm like, what's wrong with these people?
Yes.
You know, I mean, I sometimes I'm lost for words, but I had God. I had Jesus, like that song there.
Mm-hmm.
And you know, whenever things get away, and I call on him, I said, Lord, I need you. I know you're here. And, you know, I could feel his presence. Sometimes he just equipped me with words, equipped me with songs. Sometimes he tells me to open the Bible, you know. And so the journey is wonderful. You know, it was about me. The Lord organized everything. He said, go and get baptized. I said, Lord, it's Monday. All the churches are. He said, go now.
Uh-huh.
And there was someone available because
yes.
He had told me to call my sister, and I didn't know why, but my sister turned up without getting the call from me, and she was the one who arranged, like she called somebody, and they got the bishop, you know, thank God, Everton, yeah, Thomas, he turned back from going home and baptized me. The journey is wonderful. I'm, you know, sometimes, like, I'm so anointed, like when the anointed from me, I just, you know,
yes.
I do things that amaze. I am amazed. I say things that just come out of my mouth and don't know You know, I just know it's God. He said, open my mouth and I shall fill it, you know, with words.
That's
and it's
right.
just happening. It's loving.
Amen.
All right, the scripture, the
title
of the album, mm-hmm. When God Speaks. Why I titled that album When God Speaks is because God has been speaking to me so much more than when I had an encounter with him when I was like 19, 20, or when my dad had baptized us when we were little kids. I never, you know, mm-hmm. knew what Christianity was, and he didn't, you know, I didn't speak to the Lord back then. But
right.
now, like for instance, when I was here and he said, don't you remember your baptism song? I said, yes, Lord. He said, open the Bible. And when I opened the Bible, it went to John 5, it was.
Mm-hmm.
And when it was telling me about a pool in Jerusalem by the market, at a certain season, an angel would come down and trouble the water. Now, when I was growing up, I hear song, the water is troubled, my friend. I didn't know what it meant,
mm-hmm.
where it come from or anything. But when he told me to open the Bible, and if I had remembered my song, I had only a little hook from a long time, and I said, any time I get baptized, mm-hmm. I want this song to play,
mm-hmm.
you know? But I didn't write it yet. So when he said that, and I opened the Bible one time,
oh,
I didn't have to
goodness.
Spin another page, you know?
Yes.
I did not to spin another page, and when I look, I say, okay, St. John 5, boom. I'm like, what?
Yeah.
And then I start reading, and it said, after this, there was a feast of the Jews, and Jesus went up to Jerusalem. Now, there is by Jerusalem a sheep market, and it starts telling me about the pool.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm like, what? So I read all of it. And there was a man who was trying to get in the water, and he couldn't get in there because he couldn't walk. And Jesus said to him, you want to be made whole? And he said, yes, but every time I try to, when the angel troubled the water and I try to get in there, somebody going before me.
Mm-hmm.
But if you get in the water in time, if you have one foot, you have two. If whatever disease you have, you would be clean, you know?
Amen.
And you would be renewed.
Yes.
So Jesus tell him to take up him thing and walk, you know, get up and walk. So one scripture gave me three verse, and that one they have them, lead me to the water.
Yes.
I need to be baptized. Lead me to the water in the arms of Jesus Christ. Lead me to the water. Wash me of my sins. Lead me to the water, because I want to see him king. The angel has troubled the water. The angel loved the water. And all three verse come out. You know, I was in my kitchen, and I'm in the kitchen. I went to Jamaica to finish up, and I'm in the kitchen cutting up some meat, you know.
Mm-hmm.
I felt his presence. And then my mouth just opened up and started saying, it's my season for my breakthrough. I know I can tell that it's my time. The Lord is about to do something miraculous, and I can't wait to testify. And I just start shouting hallelujah and baby, whatever was coming out of my mouth.
Yes.
And right then and there, I write this song, didn't have a melody, and that is how the song come about. I'm walking on the street. I said, Lord, I want a song to just dedicate you.
Mm-hmm.
And I just feel it right there in the street. And I find myself singing, I will stand in your presence for the rest of my life. Fulfill my commitments, walk in your light. I'll stand on your promise, lift up your name, give you honor and glory for the rest of my days. You are worthy, Lord. Hallelujah, because you are worthy. And I just, I'm singing, and I felt his presence in this house, I tell you. Yes, Lord.
Amen.
I tell you, and that is how he speaks to me, and I name it that now.
Mm-hmm.
And what else did you ask me about? The journey,
and
the
message.
Title.
And a message.
And a message. Mm-hmm. The message, in every song there's a message. In every song. Lead me to the water. I imagine when, say you have a convention at a church and, you know, you ask people if they want to give their life to God and you ask them to, you know, you pray a prayer with them and ask them to, you know, accept Jesus Christ as their personal Savior. You know, if they're grown and understand, you know, you ask them if they want to be baptized and that's song and be playing that song, somebody can be singing in, lead me to the water, mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
That song you played not too long mm-hmm. ago. Normally, every time I hear it, I cry. Mm-hmm. I had Jesus.
I
was writing that
yes.
song, the Lord said to me, don't write it just about you. I was in my bedroom, in my bed, and the Lord told me that in Jamaica. And that is when I include, you know, women who have been forced into prostitution, mm-hmm. women who have been in drugs and all those things. It wasn't just about me. I am surprised that men call me crying mm-hmm. when that song played and tell me they have been raped by, you know, when mm-hmm. they were young, mm-hmm. 10 years old.
Yes.
Surprised, I didn't even know. Like, you see, the mm-hmm. boys have been through things. Yes. Have been through things.
Of course.
You know,
of course,
so that's,
of course.
The message is all over the album.
When God speaks.
Every song is a message.
When God speaks, the journey, the title, and the message. Now, many people have heard about mm-hmm. you, and you have been all over the world. But there mm-hmm. is a building that's white, and you were there back in June. On June 22nd for the Caribbean Heritage Month celebration. You want to tell them where you were?
The White House.
Oh,
the
indeed.
White House. All right,
yes.
Let me tell you how that happened. That is all God. It has nothing to do with self. Mm-hmm. It has nothing to do with mankind. Let me explain this. On the 14th of December, when the Spirit of the Lord was speaking to me in my house, when the Spirit came upon me, and I remember I was telling him that I was here, he said, I got you. I remember he said, worry not thyself. Mm-hmm. That's why you hear this song on the album. Oh, I won't worry myself.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Mm-hmm.
Cause I am Jesus, and he is my help. Oh, if tomorrow I should lose all my wealth. Oh, bless the Lord. I still won't worry. I won't worry myself. He told me, worry not thyself. He said he got me. And guess what? He told me. Mm-hmm. I remember when I was saying, sister, God said, when a plan for me, I go bigger than we. He told me that what he has planned for me is going to be bigger than us. So guess what? When I got that call from my bishop in Jamaica, he says, Marion, a lot of people are looking for you. For this call, I have to find you. There's a Dr. Dyke. Mm-hmm. He had called the radio station in Jamaica, you know, Nadine Blair radio station
Love
there, the Blair.
Mm-hmm.
And he's inviting you to come to the White House to sing a song and also, you know, to introduce some king from Africa. I said, okay. And I wasn't like, you know, I watched it first. Said Ben, I said, all right. So they email me the information, and I also start practicing the names of the king. Like one of them name was Adeya Yakumweze. Mm-hmm. You know, I start practicing. But then, listen this. You have to pay your own. You know, buy your ticket and get your hotel. And I got there.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. This theater and start to work. Satan start to work.
Yes.
When I got there, the first place that I went and sang was at a church, which I didn't know of. I didn't know that, you know, this wasn't a part of it, but mm-hmm. it's all right. I went to the church, and if I can win one soul, it's
That's
okay.
Right.
I'll go. So I went and I performed there. I then half days after, like, you know, when am I going to the White House? The person who invites me said to me, you know, it's going to take a lot of prayer.
Mm.
Going to take a lot of prayers, you know, because somebody who is more powerful than I, who have connections up in the White House, didn't want you here.
Mm-hmm.
Ah-ha! I said, well, prayer is what I have. I have two sisters at home, and I can tell you this. whenever those two women pray, and whenever I pray, things happen.
Yes.
Long time before I even got sick, I could pray for somebody and say so and so and so, and it happened. You know, I used to tell people, stop messing with me, you know, don't want me to pray for you. All right?
Yes.
So anyway, I called my sister. I said, today we're going to bind up Satan and bind up some people. We are going to bind up in followers them, in agent them. I say we are going to come up against distraction,
right,
disappointment, anything to end up. Because what had happened, the Lord led me to Acts 10. When I got the message, he led me to Acts 10 in the Bible. And I said, I opened the Bible, found it. I started reading. I didn't understand why the Lord led me to it. But it was telling me about Cornelius, who was a common unclean Gentile, you know, back in the Bible days. And also, it was telling me about Simon Peter, who was up on the roof praying. And while he was the heavens opened, and there was a sheet that was sent down with all kind of unclean animals, you know, and fowls and beasts, you know, and four-legged beasts, and a voice said, rise, Peter, kill and eat. And he said, not so, Lord. Nothing that is common or unclean have never gone to my mouth. And the Lord said to him, nothing that I cleanse, you dare not call it unclean. So I didn't understand, but then, Cornelius, now the unclean, the common, uncircumcised Gentile, he was also praying. It was a man who believed in God and prayed a lot. And while he was praying, an angel came to him and tell him to send man to Joppa and ask for one Simon Peter, whose surname is Peter, and ask him, go to him and he will tell you whatever to do. But when he was up there, when the Lord tell him three times, said, don't you dare call nothing where me cleanse unclean. He was pondering about this because he went in a trance, you know, so pondering, but then the voice of the Lord tell him, say, don't even ponder about it. There's three men downstairs waiting on you. So go down there and go with them. Ask no questions. And I sent them. When he went and went to Cornelius' house, Cornelius bowed to him and tell him, get up, because he's just a man. He said, why did you say for me? He said, well, days ago I was praying and an angel appeared to me and told me that my prayers and my good deeds, you know, came up to heaven. And the Lord said, you know, send men to Joppa for you. So while they were there, he started preaching to them, you know, giving them the word. And everybody getting a spirit. The Holy Spirit came down on everybody.
And the
whole house, Cornelius' house, they all got baptized. So when his virgin was saying, oh, yeah, mingle with them people, he said, the Spirit of the Lord spoke to me on the roof and tell me this and that and that. So what God is really saying is that none of us, him not exempt nobody, except nobody from the Holy Spirit. Anybody can. So what I pick up now was that in some people's eyes were like Cornelius, the common unclean Gentile, because I was a lady saw six, seven months ago at the time. So when I went there and I started praying and my sister started praying, I got a call from one person asking if he wanted to go to the White House. I said no, because I already signed that email that they sent to me. I am unsaved already. So why is it that you calling me? Everybody wants to be the person who he said them invite me
into
the store. I said, what's wrong? You know, not big good world. I'm good. Don't worry about it. So then I got a call from Father Isaac. Don't remember his name, Danny, I think. And he was, you know, one of the person who was really in, you know, control of that part. And he said to me, after we pray, you know, an opportunity just came up for you to go to the White House. I'm gonna send you an email right now, and I want you to sign the email and send it right back, because you know, da 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 da. I said okay. We end up talking, and I told him about my testimony. It was so powerful that he also sent an email to my bishop in Jamaica, not knowing that my bishop was in Jamaica, but my bishop made the flight and came for the next day. When I went to the White House, listen, oh, you think he's getting easy? He do some things. before I went, I bought this outfit, and this outfit fit so well. When I was putting on the dress decided that it wasn't going up. The zip wasn't going up. I say, you know, Sophia Tan, I put on this dress 2 days ago. I don't understand what's going on, but you and I now work in here because I go and leave you in here. So I call two housekeeping lady and they start pulling me up. But all them pulling up, surprisingly, the dress not going up. So they pull and they put me to lay down, and then they couldn't even speak English, you know, and they're pulling on the dress until the dress. Oh, you see, as soon as they went out the door, the dress burst. But guess what? I had bought a jacket to wear with the dress, and it had a layer at the back. So what the Lord did was lock the zip at the top, you know, close to my neck.
Yes.
And the whole middle was open. And I pulled that jacket, and I said, Satan, I say, you're staying in here. I am going where the Lord sent me. Because even before that, when everybody was saying, da-da-da, like I wasn't going, I said, Lord, you're not taking me this far to embarrass me.
That's
you
right.
Will not take me this far to embarrass me. You told me that you have what you have planned for me. So I knew the devil had no control over anything. You understand?
Mm-hmm.
So I thought, you know, I get myself together and I say, I am going. I am going. And I remember, you see, Luke 10, verse 19, behold, I gave unto you power to tread on serpents and scorpions and power of the enemy, like over the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you. After I'm going. When I got there, I was one of the first person to go in. When I go in, God put two women beside me and one behind me. Guess who they're talking about? This is the person who didn't want me there.
Didn't want you there, yes.
God is going to identify the person to me, though, you know. So this conversation starts about how rude the person was and how disrespectful the person was talking to them outside. By this now, the person come walking in the White House and they said, there she goes. So now I know who the person was by name and face now. So I said, God, you know, he's, you know.
Mm-hmm.
The lady sat in front of me and God lift her up and put her in my row, the second row, that she wanted to talk to one of the ladies. And I said, okay. Everybody was asking questions to Michelle and Mr. Obama, representative them. I didn't ask any question. That had was to do with politics. But then they put four ladies on the up there, and I one was a movie maker. You know, she make movies. So I put up my hand, but all of a sudden when I put up my hand, before I put up my hand, a man was watching me, and he came over to me and told me that his name is Marlon Hill, and he's a lawyer. And when we leave here, we're going to the fourth floor, and I'd love for you to do a song. Will you do a song? I said, the lawyer sent me here to do a song, so I will do a song. Because people was bashing and laughing and thinking, what she talk about? She go with White House. Go to which White House? You know, everybody talking, but I not pay nobody no mind, because I, you know, I didn't even know about that until somebody mentioned it days after. But listen, when I got up to ask a question,
mm-hmm.
I noticed the lady who was taking question wasn't, her face looked like it swelled. She don't want to look at me. So another lady said, keep your hand up, because it seemed like the devil is working, because that one look at that one, something is going on. Put your hand up there. But I did drop the hand already. Some put up the hand again, I put it down. Somebody said, keep up your hand. So she ended up, couldn't resist me no more. So she said, okay, we have a question over here. And I got up.
Mm-hmm.
And I told you about Cornelius.
Mm-hmm.
I said, my name is Marion Marie, also, and so on, so on. I said, 7 months ago, I was Cornelius from a river. I started telling the whole scripture. I started ministering on the scripture. And then before I was done, other Christians in the White House was finishing up reciting the last part of it,
mm-hmm.
you know, about dare not call unclean. Listen to this. Boom. When I was about to sit, when I asked the young lady, oh, would you like to do a movie about my life?
Mm-hmm.
The young lady said, you don't have to ask me twice. You know, and there was like a lot of excitement, people making noise and things, screaming
yes,
about it.
Yes.
The lady did that one day. She said, hey, hi. I said, yes, ma'am. She said, I'm going to be the producer of your movie.
Mm-hmm.
I said,
there you go.
she don't know now, you know, she don't know that I know she didn't want me there because mm-hmm. she see me as an uncle, a common, common mm-hmm. Gentile. So, mm-hmm. listen this now. I said, yeah, she said, I want to produce the movie about your life. Give me your information.
Oh, yes.
I said, okay, but I didn't give her anything.
Mm-hmm.
So when we went upstairs, she can send her back again. I don't know where she pop out of what here she pop out of, but she just pop and said to me, if you're gonna, because it was an open mic thing, mm-hmm. they don't have any mic, just mic that they talking to, but the singers wouldn't, you know, but talking to any, they just do like open mic. So everybody conversating, and you know, when you're in that place, you have to speak proper English, even, you know, some, and you act like you're all, oh, no, nice, act like them nice. So, you know, you don't speak too loud, you know, if you're having a conversation, you conversate as if, you know what I'm saying, you're whispering. This woman pop up from nowhere and said, if you want to talk, you know, you have to go outside because we want to listen to it. I said, where this woman come from? And, you know, in my mind. Anyway, my name was not on the list to sing, but God put me there.
Yes.
And I used that same song that he told me not to write just about me. And when I finished, you see, there wasn't a dry eye in the room. Maybe only her eyes were dry.
Mm-hmm.
But let me explain this to you. There was powerful women who was coming up to me telling me about their story. One woman said, I saw you in my dream 3 nights ago. The Lord had placed you in my dreams and I knew you not.
Mm-hmm.
I didn't know you until you opened your mouth and you stopped giving your testimony. I then realized what the Lord wanted me to do. He wants me to let go of my past and use my past to minister to women like us. I've studied law and I don't have 2 pennies to rub together, but you know what? I tell you, I had Jesus right there.
Yes.
So that is how I got into the
wonderful,
White House.
That
wonderful. Was how the devil fight, but the devil have no power over anything that God already ordained.
Mm-hmm. It has been my pleasure talking to you, Minister Marion Hall.
Thank you.
All those who are listening to you, because, you know, I wanted to take your interview to from another angle. Many
yes.
people have asked you about your past. They have just
yeah.
delved into it. But here you have your new album, When God Speaks. You have given me the journey, the title, the message. You have gone to the White House. You have
yeah.
been there. You have done things in your life that many people today would perhaps never be able to do. But the difference is that God is all over it. He's all up in
yeah.
your business, and you have opened the door
yeah.
for him to enter in.
He has been giving me and he has been equipping me a long time for this, you know, because
yes.
I was singing gospel long before. When I first started it, I started out singing in gospel too.
Mm-hmm.
Glory be to God. Then there was another song where I always put God into everything because remember, oh Lord, please work a miracle.
Yes,
and
yes.
take my money, take mm-hmm. my friends.
We all love that
take
one.
Take my houses, I don't need my band.
Yes,
you remember?
We so love
all
that.
Those time.
Yes.
Yeah,
yes.
I wanted to go and give my life to God, but guess what? I had so many families to support and I was
mm-hmm.
saying, Lord, how am I going to support them? How am I going to pay my bills?
Mm-hmm.
You know, even 3 or 4 years ago, when I mentioned to the world that I was going to get baptized,
mm-hmm.
and Satan sent out every agent to pull back. And I remember I lost my way because, you know, there was so much people rise up against me and I was trying to hold my mouth and I couldn't hold it. I said, Lord, if this is the test, I'm going to fail it miserably.
Yes.
And I went back to being Lady Saw.
Mm-hmm.
And I tell you, I was so embarrassed. I
mm-hmm.
felt nasty, dirty when I was done. Like I disappoint God, you know.
Yes.
And
here
I tell you,
are
I
today.
Asked him not to let go of me.
Mm-hmm.
And he didn't let go of me.
Well, here you
and
are
I
today.
I so love him.
Yes, and keep loving him. Keep loving him. How can they get a copy of your new album, When God Speaks?
Okay. My album is all over the internet. On Google Play, Amazon. It's on iTunes. It's on over 600 distributors, and it's Deepal who is distributing it.
Okay.
You know, but before I go, I just want to share 1 Peter 5, verse 8 with people over. It said, be sober, be vigilant, because you're adverse with the devil,
mm-hmm.
like a roaring lion walketh about, seeking
yes.
whom he may devour. when I was Lady Saul, my heart wants to go to God. I wanted to give my life to Him. But the devil was always giving me what I needed. When I said I wanted another house or another car, I start getting fast money, quick money, happening so fast. And you think it was God, but it was not of God. Mm-hmm. You know, it was of the devil. And the devil will give you worldly things out there, material things for you to stay. And the more you get, the more you're going to want. So you have some people that say they're waiting. They wait at the right time. You don't know when God is coming. It can be tomorrow.
That's
don't
right.
Let the devil pull you in, because there's a scripture that said, no, unto him that is able to do exceedingly
right.
abundantly above all that we ask or think, according to the power that worketh in us. God can give you there's a sense of joy and peace and comfort within me that I can't explain to anyone. So just love the Lord, give your life to Him, seek Him, you know, submit yourself therefore to God, resist the devil and he will flee. James 4 verse 17. I love you, brothers and sisters.
Yes.
I love the Lord. I'm brand new. He washed me. I'm a new creature. I can't explain to you.
The joy, the joy.
When I love Him, lady.
Yes, the joy. Over. There's a song which says, look at me, I'm a testimony. So you have a testimony. Blessings to you. God bless and keep you and cover
God
bless you. And I'm so... you know, appreciative that you spent the time with me this evening and the audience.
Thank you so much.
Here
there's
at Lincoln
so much
Radio.
To talk about, so we have to do it another time.
Indeed.
But bless the Lord, glorify Him, and lift His name high every day. Love you, Lady D. Thanks
love you,
for the time.
Minister Hall.
The album is all over. Go get it. Thank you.
Blessings to you. All right, ladies and gentlemen, that's the voice of Minister Marion Hall. And I tell you, she is on fire. Coming up in a few, it's time for our Fun in the Sun promo. And we have Reverend Gladstone Johnson. He's our executive director for the Fun in the Sun. And we have Billy right here. He's one of our artists who will be performing this coming Saturday. Stay with me. Don't go anywhere.
Some people think me I'm going to turn back.
I'm not
but
turning back.
I'm fire your heart.
Hot.
I'm fire for Jesus.
Yes, sir.
I'm fire for Jesus.
Yes, sir.
None can derail me.
None
can derail me.
I'm on fire for Jesus.
Jesus.
I'm on fire for my King.
Fire.
I'm on fire for Jesus.
Jesus.
I can feel the fire burning deep within. I'm on fire for Jesus.
Come on now.
I'm on fire for my King. I'm on fire.
Welcome to the Monday Drive afternoon.
Good evening to each and every one.
Good evening to you.
Lady D, give thanks to God and Jesus to rise you up this morning only and to walk and pray to the student and sit in the air chair.
Thank you, Yvonne. How are you?
What's my Minister Hall? Is her name a Marion Minister Hall? What's her name?
Minister Marion Hall.
Oh, I won't call a lady sir no more.
No, man, we don't use that God, around
God,
here.
The God, God of Jesus, move her in a different
that's
way right.
right
now.
She's on fire
she's
for the master.
To rise up upon that all I ran to walk.
That's
to
right.
Each of them is living here. Give thanks to God of Jesus to keep us whatever we are doing, because you know what happened? This year does not promise to no one, but God of Jesus give it to us.
That's right.
And like even I said, each and every one, my God, is not dead. He's alive!
That's right, Yvonne.
And ladies, like I said, happy birthright to my sister Faith, who makes 62 years old today, my mother firstborn.
Wonderful.
And Jesus gives thanks to the word of my soul.
All right. Blessings, Yvonne. Happy birthday to sis.
I love to each and every one who's listening.
All right. Bless you, love. Ladies and gentlemen, we've had a great afternoon so far. I started it at 5 o'clock, and right now it's time for us to get into our Fun in the Sun promotional bit, because this coming Saturday, starting at 10 a.m. to 5 p.m., it's not going to be the same. It is not going to be the same. It's going to be so different that you're all going to say, my, oh my, where was I in the past 3 years? This year is going to be the fourth year, and we have really gone above and beyond to make this event the one that we would like it to be, that it will touch somebody's heart, that somebody will be delivered, that people will just say, I need God, I can't do it without him, why is it that I hadn't found him before? But in this world there are so many things to distract us, and who is the mastermind behind all of that? The enemy, the devil, Lucifer, he's out there to distract. And so I'd like to say good afternoon to all those of you who are listening right now. We're about to get into our segment, and if you've not heard about Fun in the Sun, well, our executive director, Reverend Glad Johnson, is here, and he will be sharing so much with you. And I will be having online Dwight Trouter. He's one of our performing artists. We also have Bill E. Wright here, who is no stranger to my platform Inside the Zone. He has been here before. And we will just be telling you what's going to be taking place on the grounds of Evander Charles Soccer Field. This is how I do it for you this afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome, welcome, welcome.
Well, then we're going to sing us some Jamaican song.
Andy King, Fun in the Sun, and the High School of Contemporary Arts presents Fun in the Sun.